do you?
Playing the bear today.
Can I buy a ticket, please?
Make your way through the doors on either side of me.
Tell you a morality tale from when our country was young that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle, "and he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him."
"I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends."
The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter.
"It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time."
The lazy possum said,
"Well, there's an abundance of food. Maybe I'll just store some in my pouch."
Even his squirrel friends made fun of Bear. They laughed and laughed and squibbled and squabbled.
"Chunky needs a nap.
Fatty Goody Two Shoes does what he's told."
Bear was very sad. But he was a good bear, and he always did what Old Man Wind told him. He went and found a den, snuggled inside, and fell fast asleep. Bear snored and snored for many days. When he woke up, he saw spring had come. He was very hungry, so he walked outside. As the snow melted, he saw all his friends who hadn't listened frozen and just ready to be eaten. And that's why the bear hibernates. So listen to your elders and do just what you're told.
Good one. See you soon.
Good morning, friend.
Sounds like
for the blind? Is someone there?
Welcome. Come on in.
Anything to spare for a blind man?
I'll find it. Hell, on a Friday night, I lose half of everything I own.
Poor blind man! Can anyone spare a coin for a blind man?
Good saddles is almost as important as a good horse. I got one of them myself. Adding on to a saddle helps personalize it. That's a nice addition on a saddle.
Sure is.
Little fine grooming always sets off a horse. A few careful trims, and this horse will look just fine.
Take care of that eye, Morn, and come back and see me.
Oiga, careful!
Don't what get your back up, I'm on a kid.
Get it, Cloud.
Hey, the performers asked me to come see them here. Help them out with something up in Van Horn.
All right, I'll let them know you're in. Curtain's just about to come up, so why don't you take a seat, then come back and see me after the show. All right.
Thank you. Welcome. Welcome, everyone. I am your host, Aldridge T. Abington. Thank you. Yes, Aldridge T. Abington. Few men have had a career more crowded with incident and various intercourse with the world than I. During extensive travel through this and foreign lands, I have procured a show so fantastical there exists nothing like it. Anywhere. In an effort to bring this entertainment to even the poorest dreamer of dreams, I have determined the ticket price should be very low, and the show held without a profit. To me, it's true. For it is blessing enough to bring these gifted artists to you.
Yeah!
I met these odd fellows in a tavern in some godforsaken place. Entertaining cretins. They're quite a capricious bunch. Presenting Miss Marjorie and her medical miracles.
Y'all see this?
Well, hello, Sandy! Hello! Oh, isn't this a fun?
seats and hold on to your lunches, because we have a show for you! Without further ado, let me present Miss Marjorie's medical miracle, Bertram the Pinheaded Giant!
Look at that big guy!
Even as smart as he looks. But when he lacks in brain, he makes up for in brawn. Our half-witted Hercules is as strong as a bull. He's sweet as me. You, sir, would you assist?
Me?
Hell yeah! Come on up!
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, get out of there!
We want more!
Young lad, I want you to hit him right here, right in the breadbasket. Go on, give him a real big suck.
I don't know.
Ah, the only danger is breaking your arm. What are you afraid of?
Come on, do it, do it.
All right.
Bring up more freaks.
Damn it.
Sometimes he gets carried away.
What kind of a two-bit show is this? Your freak nearly killed me.
And a master of
preparations! Oh my god!
And dissipation! And even the art of transfiguration!
Wow! Alright! Oof! What the hell is this?
I have mastered hypnosis! Telekinesis, telepathy, and escapology. And now, for my next feat, I will relieve Miss Marjorie of her
fright. What the
hell? This
robbery!
Oh,
Lord!
Where
did
her gloves go?
You're doing a nasty little pervert.
Oh, damn.
What?
She's hot as
damn it! We were gonna give them a show.
Not like that, you're not.
I give up.
You all see this?
Well, tiny people and tiny-headed giants, curious things. They are a delight and can make you money. So, before you snuff out that oddly shaped baby, bring them to me. I discovered this next act in a tiny village in Italy. Truly the most exotic of places in the world. He was just a 10-year-old boy. I raised him. I bathed him.
Yeah!
I shaved him from head to toe.
Did you hear that?
He is truly a wonder to behold. Presenting Benjamin Lazarus.
And mystical prowess, my dear ladies and gentlemen. Now, it's unfortunate fact that in this mortal coil we are all born to suffer from all manner of maladies in daily life.
Yeah.
Who here has not had a friend or loved one near death's door? From coal gas fumes, typhoid fever, diphtheria, or the bite of a rabid animal. The greatest wealth is your health. All the gold in the world cannot purchase it, and yet it is the most delicate and tenuous of all life's gifts. And nothing knocks down death's door faster than this. A man cannot outrun a bullet. Many fools have tried and failed in this endeavor, including the tonic salesman I caught bedding my wife.
I joke.
I assure you, he has met his maker and they are playing gin rummy among the molten lava of Hades. I have traveled all around the world, delighting young and old with all manner of feats of amazement, but none are as dangerous as what I am prepared to attempt tonight.
Oh, I can't wait.
I will hand this Didi Packenbush revolver over to my assistant and stand at considerable distance across the stage. She will point the revolver at my head and pull the trigger using lightning-quick reflexes taught to me by a tiny man I met in the distant Orient. I will catch the bullet in my teeth. Yes, my teeth. To prove that these are indeed live rounds, if my sharpshooting assistant would be so kind as to shoot this bottle of lalicola off my head.
This is insane.
Yeah!
Off my head.
Here we go!
Careful. I could do without a bullet in the brain right now.
Okay. Oh my God, you're what?
Oh my God!
Ain't no show better!
That bit always scares me. Now, observe as I, the great Benjamin Lazarus, will do what no man has ever done and cheat death!
As if it were nothing.
What is he doing?
Christ.
Let's do that again.
All right. Oh, I can't take it.
You're pulling my leg. This is a bunch of dang balderdash.
Damn.
A skeptic.
I'm trying to watch the show.
And Benjamin Lazarus, I assure you, I am not participating in some hoax or carnival ruse. These bullets are 100% real.
Whoa.
In fact, I challenge any member of the audience to come forward with their own firearm, and I will yet again display my uncanny skill to catch a bullet in my teeth.
Did you hear that?
Is no one man enough?
You
come
all pay up!
Someone
to watch
stand
this.
Up and take a shot.
Okay. If nobody else is gonna expose this phony, then I will.
All right.
I trust you are a good shot, sir.
I can shoot a fly's wings off at 100 paces.
Excellent, my good man. Now, ready? Take aim.
Oh, the fight is too much.
And fire.
He's gonna knock his teeth out.
Is he okay?
Gentlemen, death is just an illusion, after all.
Yes! Truly A feat of incredibility. I told you that boy would bring you all manner of personal satisfaction. He certainly does me. Now, I discovered this next remarkable woman in a lost jungle, deep in the wilds of Colombia, where they do not wear clothes. She breathes fire. Yes, she does. And for those with the universal and not unworthy curiosity, yes, I can attest, she does emit fire from almost every orifice in her body. Presenting Antoinette San Servino! Incredible. Bravo. Though I must warn you, court her at your peril. She'll not nurse babies. She'd turn them into bacon. Thank you. Thank you. He liked that joke. Yes. I discovered this next woman in the kingdom of Poland, where she sang by the roadside, subsisting on coppers tossed at her feet. Miss Robin Koninski!
Oh, thanks for joining us today. This here is a new song about a so-called modern improvement you may have become aware of called the telephone. Yeah. This new machine will carry a facsimile of your voice from Blackwater to Valentine to Saint Denis, and they propose to distribute them to all manner of places so that no matter where you are, somebody is looking for you. A wise man prayed that one day we may all eventually be gathered together in a heaven of everlasting rest and peace and bliss, except for the inventor of the telephone, because someone is always calling, saying, hello, hello, hello. I've got a little baby, but he's out of sight. I talk to him across the telephone. I can't see my honey, but he's mine, all right. This gal just can't leave a man alone. Every single morning you will hear me yell. He sent to fix me up along the line. They connect me with my honey and I ring the bell. And this is what I say to baby mine. Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello, my ragtime gal. Send me a kiss by wire. Blackwater calling. Hello. This morning through the phone they said he'd been with Bess and told me exactly where he's at. Now I'm headed out of town to his address. That man better hold on to his hat. I sure do worry that the wires might get crossed and it will separate me from my baby.
She is a siren, singing from the rocks as men bash into them to their doom. Thank you for joining me for tonight's entertainment. I hope it has delayed for at least a moment the crushing and remorseless misery of this mortal coil. Good night, dream well, and come back soon.
Quite something.
Yeah, I gotta go deal with this. There's something here for you.
Oh, good luck.
These novelty acts.
Don't get this with dancing girls.
We are departing soon. Everyone on board. Come on, folks. All aboard.
Evening.
Well, excuse you.
Bother you for a minute of your time?
All right.
Can I tell you a little about what we're doing here?
Sure.
Less than a minute, I promise. We're trying to raise money to build an expansion to the Quincy Harris Memorial Hall, a shelter for homeless veterans and their families. Can you help? A donation of $20 would put us well on our way. There are many on hard times. Many children without fathers.
$20 ain't no chicken feed, but sure, I can help you out.
That's very kind. What is your name, sir?
Arthur Morgan.
Your donation will be acknowledged on a founder's plaque when the building is completed. You have a great day, Mr. Morgan.
Folks,
have a blessed evening.
Have a good night.
Good evening.
Are you in need of a head doctor?
Departing soon.
damn way!
Take much?
You bastard!
Another soul going down to hell.
What happened? Looks like he's worse for wear.
Okay, off you go then.
Hello. New face there. Right, let's see. All made to measure.
You hear Jacob spend a whole month's wage for the deal of New California monkeys? Not sure if this is a rumor or not, but they said the Cornwall Railroad and Central Union are in a big fight.
You seem the ambitious type. If you want a unique garment, you need to bring me a unique belt. It'll be worth it.
You holding up okay, I hope.
至少我仲睇到嘢。
Well, that's just well.
Some of the things folk bring me to work with. Dead squirrels, cats full of buckshot. City folk, eh?
Hello.
Hey, move it!
Check it out.
Hey! Come on now!
Out of the way!
Don't tell me.
Yourself,
let
partner.
Me vote. Let me vote. I can say this all day. Let me vote. Let me vote. Let me vote. I will say this for as long as it takes. Come
Hello.
On, people.
Come on in.
Let me vote.
You'll find only the best of the best in there. I get all sorts walking into this establishment, but they all end up looking better when they walk out.
I want to vote. I insist that I deserve the right to vote.
I only stock the best in my shop. Buy from me, and you'll never be disappointed. All right then, but if there was anything in there that caught your eye, it'll be right here waiting for you.
Now, let me have a look.
No problem at all. If you change your mind, it'll be here waiting for you.
I have a feeling we'll be back.
Well, I've been hearing that them Hawthorns are gonna be selling that big house of theirs soon.
It's on everyone's list.
Thank you.
day.
Someone showed up.
This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We're just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big. But his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we can take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle?
Well, Arthur.
Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
Can I drive?
Nope.
Ready? Let's get out of here.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of hers. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. The smug fucker.
Okay. So what's she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep. Using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting, she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook nose, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right feller for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. They really bury some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy, easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still. Tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
We just robbed their horses, too.
That was you? Jesus.
So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they've taken on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery, that's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then. Yeah.
Them Grays English.
Excuse me?
You not worried about them Grays.
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Maybe you're right.
You know what? Here. I'll go hiding back. If you can act naturally and stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
I'm not gonna go that far.
Here, stay out of sight. I'll do the talking.
Hold him right there.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal, in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there,
okay,
they said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink, Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? And you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here.
Yeah, it's straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah. When they said they was looking for more drivers in town, I jumped at the chance. I never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. Bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horse is like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. Quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Huh. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy. Because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh? Mm. Well, the average man sups on shite, yeah? Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah. Come on, Arthur. What are you playing at?
I was enjoying the monologue. I'm glad I'm not your brother.
Where?
Let's get on with this.
I'm not the one who was dawdling. Okay. We can hold up in here till it gets dark.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine, and then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained, and that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
This should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was born burning down manor houses.
We'll burn quietly.
Quiet. There's someone coming on the left.
Oh, hey. Well, I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed at the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Payroll.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
Just let me deal with our friend here. You douse the fields, I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble. Do it. That's good. That's good for here.
We give this a quick dousing as well.
Those bloody fields to the ground.
I got the red head!
You keep warning.
You pay for this! You ain't getting out of this alive. You ain't leaving here!
You won't hurt them.
Somebody shoot him already!
We got company. Look out!
Hey! Where the hell are you running off to?
This is a goddamn mess.
Come on!
Leave
didn't tell you there'd be an army of them?
They didn't tell me nothing. Nearly there. Money's worth, darling.
Let's just get out of here first.
What? I think we lost them.
That we did.
Quite a night.
Sure.
Interesting little fight Dutch has put us into the middle of here.
I hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
Well, what now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
Oh.
Been watching you.
Hello.
Like your new home?
I won't miss that other place, that's for sure.
Keep your nose clean. Micah?
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called...
Hey, Molly, where's Dutch?
Well, however it goes.
I'm not sure all that line of thought serves you or me very well.
That's because, Cowpoke, you are a man of profoundly limited intelligence.
No doubt.
Well, you and the old man and Dutch have been running around, digging us ever deeper into shit. Old Mr. Pearson might have gone and lightened the load a little. Pearson! Ain't you curious?
I guess.
Gentlemen.
Dutch, you tell him, fat man.
It's peace, Dutch. The O'Driscolls. I think there's a way.
What on earth are you talking about?
Get the words out properly, fat man.
I met a couple of the O'Driscoll boys on the road in the town, and things were about to get ugly. But you know how I am in a fight, huh? Like a corner tiger. Anyway, somehow it didn't, but we got to talking, and they suggested a parlay to end things like gentlemen.
Gentlemen. Combe O'Driscoll. Have you lost your minds?
You're always telling us, Dutch, do what has to be done, but don't fight wars ain't worth fighting.
They want a parley? It's a trap.
Well, of course, it's probably a trap, but what do we got to lose finding out?
Get shot.
We ain't getting shot because you'll be protecting us. It's a trap, you shoot a lot of them. If it ain't a trap, that's slim chance.
I don't see the point in any of this.
It's a chance you've gotta take.
I killed Combe's brother a long time ago. Then he killed a woman I loved dear.
As you say, it's a long time ago, Dutch.
Let's go. You and me, with Arthur protecting us, no one else.
What about me?
This ain't the time for tigers, my friend.
Fine.
Mount up then, Morgan.
Let's go then.
You know, I've been fighting Combe for so long now, I can barely remember a time when it was different.
And you're still fighting him now. Make no mistake of that.
Here he goes, Doubting Thomas. Is there any plan you ain't sour on?
Well, maybe you're right. Just nervous. Let's not waste any more lives needlessly.
I ain't costing lives here. I'm saving them. What did you say? We had Pinkertons coming after us.
Because of Blackwater.
And Leviticus Cornwall and his private army. Then who knows when this local hillbilly thing will come to a head, hmm? Can we really afford to be fighting on all these fronts? And O'Driscoll.
There is wisdom in that.
I hope so, gentlemen, but like I said, I'm nervous.
Look. You ain't even going to be the one in danger. We'll get on over there, find a nice perch for you to settle into. You got that rifle, don't you?
Yeah.
Then me and Dutch walk right in to the lion's den. With you to cover us, hmm?
Okay. Just keep calm, unless I give you a reason not to.
Oh, we'll be fine. We got you.
I will do my best.
Oh, my dear and trusted friend, with you watching over me, I would walk into hell itself.
As would I.
From the look of them.
I don't like having eyes on us.
We're close. You'll be the eyes soon enough. Maybe he's right, Dutch. Maybe I have pushed too hard. Got us into situations that could have been safer. I see all those mouths we gotta feed, and I dream too big, caring too much. That's my problem.
Caring too much? There's no such thing.
This is horse shit from both of you.
It might be. Micah might be full of shit. Colm O'Driscoll might be full of shit. The promise of this great nation, men created equal, liberty and justice for all, that might be nonsense too, but it's worth trying for. It is worth believing in. Can't you see that, friend?
I don't know.
Try. All I ask is you try.
All right, cowpoke. You're gonna peel off up ahead. We'll be meeting down on the plain. Find a spot just above us where you can keep an eye on things.
All right, all right. However this shakes out, let's aim to meet back at the fork in the road afterwards.
We'll be there, partner.
Yeah.
Hello, Dutch. It's been a while.
Sure.
So, how's your gang doing?
They still believing in you? Better world. Pure world.
How's that coming along?
Just fine.
How's that score you stole off us?
Which one?
Oh, I like that. It's like I said, this is a charismatic leader.
A lot of heat on us this time. Both of us. Whole heap of trouble.
They offered me a price, Dutch, to bring you in.
Why didn't you take it?
Well, still might.
I am sorry about your brother.
Yeah, well, I never liked him much.
I liked Annabelle.
You always loved the ladies, Dutch Vanderlyn. I like that about you.
What are we doing here, Colm? Is this thing over?
Hello, sugar. You ain't dead, is you? Not...
I don't know. Colm's got a sense.
Handing him over to the lords. I don't know. Strange times.
They killed Seamus. Fuck the whole lot of them. With this fella, Colm's right. We can draw them all back.
True.
He's escaping. Shoot him. Relax. Relax. I got it. Did I kill you?
Not yet. No, of course not. Not yet.
But I will.
Ah!
Finally! What is weapons over there?
Morgan, it's good to see you.
Hello, Cole.
How's the wound?
I hardly feel it.
You will. Septic, it ain't nice. Now, tell me, fine gun like you, why are you still running around with old Dutch? Could come ride with me and make real money.
It ain't about the money, Cole.
No, no. It's Dutch's famous car. You killed a whole bunch of my boys. Six-point cabin.
I ain't got no clue what you're talking about.
Oh, you lie, my friend. And I thought Dutch preached true.
Let me go, Cole, and end all this crap between you two. We all got real problems now.
The way I see it. They get him. They forget about me.
They ain't the forgetting sort. If I were you, I'd run as soon as I had the money.
Oh, I know you would. But see, we lure an angry Dutch in to rescue you. Grab all of you and hand you in. Then disappear.
So you only met with him to grab me?
Of course. He's gonna be so mad. He's gonna come raging over here. And a whole lot of you. And the law will be waiting for him. Oh, Arthur. Arthur, I missed you.
In a minute. What the hell?
Hey,
What's he still doing down there? It's one thing torturing a man, it's another thing putting him through stories of the homeland. He better hurry it up. I don't want to be here when the law comes for that side of beef.
My dear boy, what?
They got me. I got away.
Yeah, you did.
Miss Grimshaw, I need help! Reverend Swanson!
He was gonna set the law on us!
No, of course he was!
I'm sorry, Arthur.
It is a bit late for apologies. Swanson!
Mr. Morgan, you're safe now.
Oh, let's get him to bed.
You are safe now, Arthur. You're safe now.
That's pretty, it does. That's real pretty.
Miss Grimshaw, will you sit with him a while?
Of course. You'll be okay, Mr. Morgan. You're home.
I thought I'd be burying you, Mr. Morgan.
Well, not quite yet, Reverend.
Good. How you feeling?
About the same as you.
I'm sorry to hear that. Well, take care of yourself.
You too.
Thank you.
Listen, Morgan, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I thought they would shoot me, not you.
What happened?
Yeah, the whole thing was odd. I kept waiting for them to jump us, and then they left, and we assumed we'd meet you on the trail back. You never showed up.
No. I was getting special guest treatment from Como Driscoll.
So I heard. I'm sorry. One time I try to be wise and careful and make a goddamn fool of myself. That'll teach me.
Maybe I do. I don't really know anymore. I had a family
once. Come on, girl.
Are you busy, Arthur?
Why?
Well, I know you think I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. Well, who would have even thought? Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed men attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot.
What are you playing at? I don't have time for this.
So where do we find this friend of yours?
Roads.
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
Well, lead the way and we'll find out.
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats?
Among other things, I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
You're too far ahead. Come on. Hang back a bit and let me do the talking.
We don't want to scare him off.
Oh, I almost forgot. Bill asked me to give you a message to meet him here in town as soon as you can. Something to do with the Greys. I thought I'd nab you first.
You did? Okay. Thanks.
Hello, Alden.
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman. Terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No man at all. My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Dear.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay, well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there, a feller called Hector. He's also one of the, what did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it, discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden, or should I say, adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
What the hell? What's that?
I thought you might like to see that pantomime.
River Road through Siltwater Strand, he said.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me. Okay, let's go. This way. What did I tell you? Simple as can be. Seems a lot of the station workers are in on it these days. Earning a pittance, the unions are whipping them up, so they want something on the side. Like he said, there, Strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to Strawberry after all that market business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble, you gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel. And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
If anything goes wrong, let's meet back here at this crossroad, okay?
All right.
Damn it!
Here we are. This is the spot. Hold. Okay. This should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. So what were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strongbox, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strongbox, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strongbox without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is damson.
Oh, very good, Alden, very good.
Of course, if anything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do.
Hold tight. They'll be here soon.
There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you. And please leave that gun in its holster for once. I'll ride ahead and get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you or you'll scupper the whole thing. No! I hope you don't mind my singing.
Not at all.
I'm preparing for a show.
It's a free country.
Did you say a show?
It's a small benefit to build up in Blackwater. Just...
Mrs. Chester Damson.
I flatter, buddy.
Stop the coach, my good man! Stop the coach!
Whoa! Miss Damson, why did you stop singing?
The New York audience, they were rather cruel.
New Yorkers are prigs and fools who believe Westerners don't know anything about culture.
I couldn't agree more.
Could you? It's such a small show, but would you season something for me? I'm looking for a mezzo-soprano.
I don't know.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth.
You treat a lasciator, non lasciar the trio.
We should move the roads. They're not safe.
My good man, they're perfectly safe.
Can we go, please? I got a train to catch.
I want you to be quiet, you horrible little man.
One more time, from the top. Madam, I've heard enough. Might I have your card? The event is on the 23rd of this month. I can't say enough about Mrs. Damson. Magnifico. So sorry, gentlemen, for the interruption. Farewell. Finesse for once. Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, jolly good. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.